Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Father, we give you praise. We magnify your name. You are God. You are worthy to be praised. Thank you for the opportunity to share your word again today. Thank you for your spirit that teaches us all things. Thank you for forgiveness of sins. Thank you for you do mighty things. You do awesome things. You are a faithful God. And awesome is your name. We worship you. We glorify your holy name. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So, beloved, today we'll be talking about overcoming strongholds. Overcoming strongholds. And to help us to go through this discussion, we'll be looking at 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Verse 4 and 5. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4 and verse 5. If you are there, you can shout a big hallelujah. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 4 and 5. It says, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds." Verse 5 says, "Casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ." Hallelujah. May God bless the reading of His word in our lives in Jesus' name. Amen. So, beloved, one of the things that happens in our life when we become children of God is that we move from, you know, it's not like we move from warfare to peace. We actually move from a battle we could not win to a new battle which we cannot lose. Now, majorly that battle takes place in our mind. And today we are talking about one of them, strongholds. Strongholds. Now, it is important that we understand that we wage these wars daily in our mind, and they are more or less defensive warfare that the devil has cast against God's people. Now, they come in different forms. Scripture talked about them in Ephesians chapter 6 and in verse 12 when he talked about the different fiery darts that we deal with, whether they are temptations, whether they are deceptions, what are the accusations. In all, each of these are tied or pointed at different levels of attack from the devil. Now, why do we talk about strongholds today? Because, you know, strongholds are incorrect thinking patterns, okay, that are based on deception that the devil has sown in the life of God's people. And the tendency is to use this stronghold against us. The reason is because stronghold has tremendous power to affect our emotions and feelings. Because with this stronghold, many of us are in constant struggle. We are constantly fighting. So the fight of faith that we have been called to address and deal with is to fight our way out of oftentimes this emotional and struggles and these feelings, whether they come in the form of anger, whether they come in the form of new creations that the devil has set up for us. The reality, my dear friends, is that this perception and guilt that we accept as a result of the very corny and tricky modes that the devil sows seeds in our life are countless measures that the devil uses to keep us living in defeat, because we are deceived and we have embraced the lies that the devil has sold to us. Beloved, you see, the beautiful thing about our Lord Jesus Christ is that all believers have authority over the devil. Yes, Praise God. The scripture we read today in 2 Corinthians 10 and verse 4 said the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They are not of the flesh. They are not of earthly nature. But they are mighty in God for pulling down strongholds. Praise the Lord. See, recall that in another scripture, specifically in Luke 10 and verse 17, God told us that even the demons are subject to us in God's name. Praise the Lord. See, it is very important that for us to break the stronghold that has kept us down, this stronghold, this incorrect thinking pattern, these incorrect patterns that we have held on to, hallelujah, based on the deception that the devil has given unto us, to understand that we have an authority in God. We need to use the authority we have in the Lord Jesus Christ to bind and take authority over the Satan's activity. We must stay in the place of prayer. Yes, prayer is the key. Then we must understand that the only way you can displace incorrect thinking pattern in your life is to displace it with establishing the presence of God in your life. When the devil, see, scripture said light and darkness cannot stay side by side. No, one must depart for the other. So if you invite the light of God in, darkness will disappear. Of course, James 4:7 says, resist the devil and he will flee from you. Now, you must understand that when we give no place or vacancy to the devil departs. So you must fill the void in our life, in your life, with the word of God. Give no place to the devil, no place to the devil. Occupy yourself with God daily. Let him clothe you with his armor. Once we are fortified, take up daily the full array of God's spiritual equipment. Then you'll find that scripture tells us in Ephesians 6 verse 13 to 17 that we will put on the full armor of God, God's word, to start with. Another links to the armor, we begin to not only resist satanic assault, we will be ready to engage the strongholds that are in our lives and in the life of others. See, beloved, listen, the battle that we have today is one that we can win, but we can only win it with Christ at the center of our life. And that's why we invite you today to make Jesus the center of your life by saying this following prayer with us. Dear Lord Jesus, we realize we are sinners and we need your forgiveness. We believe that you died for us on the cross of Calvary and rose from the dead, so we could wash, so you could wash away our sin. This morning we give our life to you and we ask that you be the master of our soul, the savior of our life, and that with you we can do all things. Thank you, Father, for salvation of our soul and for forgiveness of sins, in Jesus' name. If you have made that prayer this morning, call the numbers on the screen. We'll be there to pray with you and to guide and pray with you. And as we walk with you daily in this journey with Jesus Christ, God bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.